The tentative deal may not cut Social Security or Medicare benefits, but as 4029's Kyle Leinberger found out, there are some in our area who worry the deal won't do enough.
Yeah, Kelly, they want the government to get its spending under control.
Carolyn Hurd has heard enough from members of Congress.
They're just not working together. It's like they're just fighting amongst themselves like a bunch of two-year-olds.
She's confident a deal will be agreed to before Tuesday's deadline, but thinks the whole thing was handled badly.
They're just scaring the people. You're not going to get your Social Security. You're not going to get your Medicare. And this is what a lot of people depend on.
It's caused me to become more politically active than I've ever been in my life. I think we're in a desperate situation.
Dorothy Shemwell keeps a notepad at her side while she watches the news, listening for things that concern her.
I don't hesitate to pick up the phone and call the president's information line or the senators or Congresswoman Lawmakers because I think it's very important that they listen to us for a change.
Shemwell believes the country's failure to balance the budget will eventually reduce the standard of living in the United States.
I have a 3-year-old great-grandchild that's not going to have anything like my children have, mm-hmm. or their children even. If we don't do something very quickly, very radically, we've got to stop this spending.
It would be such a mess. People would be killing each other. They would be robbing banks, gas stations, no matter what you could think of to get some food. And then we're going to really be in trouble.
Hurd says lawmakers need to focus on domestic issues first.
Help our own people. I mean, we're paying all these taxes and we're not really getting a lot of benefits from it. We're just keep going deeper and deeper into the hole.
We can't afford this kind of thing anymore. We've just spun ourselves into oblivion.
Those ladies have strong opinions, but what do you think? Join the conversation on Facebook.com/4029news.